Hello everyone and welcome to the Festival Dance Workshop. I'm Melinda Sullivan, Dance Director at Boston Early Music Festival. And with me are our BEMF dancers, Caitlin Klinger, who will demonstrate, our young artist graduate, Alex Meeth, and our very special accompanist, Sarah Darling. Today we'll start with a warm-up. We'll do some bending and rising. We'll make some combinations with pas de bourrées and coupés. And we will focus on staying grounded even when we are risen on the balls of the feet, especially for pirouette and for our pas grave. So shall we begin? Let's breathe. Let's start in parallel and let's all breathe together. So we're just going to take a breath in, pressing our feet down. And when you're ready to exhale, open the arms. Let all your air out. Let's stay nice and long in this beautiful column of the body. One more time. Press the feet down. Inhale. And exhale. We want to involve our whole body. How about some shoulder circles? See behind you. See around you. Know where you are in the room. And let's lift our shoulders up. Inhale. Exhale. Bend the knees. Reach the arms out to the sides. Let's slide our shoulder blades. How are they feeling today? Crunchy or smooth?
A little crunchy.
A little crunchy? And just stretch your back. And let's stretch our front. And come back to center. We want to keep nice ease in our major joints here. That will help us stay grounded. All right, let's start today with pliés. Let's come to parallel with our feet and just open the toes and close the toes and open the toes and close. Make that as slow or as fast as you like. I'm going to finish in a first position turned out. Thinking up the front of the hips, up the whole front of the body, and let this energy flow down the back of your neck, down your waist, down the backs of your legs and your heels into the floor. And right away we'll use our beautiful arms in front of the torso. We'll take a demi-plie. 1, 2, 3, turn the palms as we come up. 1, 2, 3, 1, and then for our instep, pressing down to rise up, reach the top, and resist as the heel comes down. Oh, there, one more time. It's a demi. Arise, a demi. Try to connect the down to the up, pressing down, da-da, resisting, lowering. Let's take that 3 times. Let's take it 4 times. And then right away, we'll open to second position. And in second, let's come to a double arm. If that's too complicated to think of the arms, you can always just bring the palms up as you did in the first position. Sarah, we'll make this a nice long one because we're going to come to third position and do the same. Demi and arise. Demirari. Rising up and down. Let's take it twice on one leg. Shift. Twice the other. We want to stand on your whole foot. So let's come back to first position. I'll count us in with 2 measures. 1, 2, 3, ready. Here we go. Slowly rise. Long back of neck. Let's repeat that. Take your time shifting forward. Let's do that again. Breathing. Ah. Slow rise. Think up the hips as we lower down. Beautiful. One more time. Lower. Second position. How about a little quicker? And ah. Double arm. Take your time. Shifting the weight from the heels to the balls. Beautiful. One more time. Let let's shift to third position. And opposition. Slow rise. You're still on both feet, coming down. Let's do that again. Rising. And your other third position. Here we go. Nice release on the demi-plie. Pressing down. Tailbone down. Last one. Beautiful. And let's lower and finish standing on both feet. Gorgeous, beautiful. The intelligence is in the instep there. So from our brain to our instep, that's what will help us keep, stay grounded. Shall we do a quick shift? Let's take a demi and a shift and a demi and a demi. We're shifting onto one leg, so it must be very stable. We'll do it four times, alternating one and a one and a one and a one and a one. And then guess what? Caitlin, would you show us rising and shifting? Rise and a shift. And that's it. It's not an easy exercise, but it's necessary. I recommend 100 times. So let's do shift to the right side the first time, and then when we rise, we'll do shift to the right side. We really want the gesture leg to be free in the hip socket, so try not to hike it up in. A one, and a one, and a ready, let's plie, and a demi. Again. You can try that again. You can stop your class right here and rewind and do that exercise many times, especially the rise and shift, yes? So the weight is still over the heels of the feet even as the heel is lifted up. All right, let's go for some pliable feet here. You can think of pliable palms of hands also, and maybe even jaw and throat for our tendu. We'll take our tendu to the front and the side, and then we'll do the other leg to the front and the side, so we will not do to the back, but you can practice that at home. With opposition, we'll brush out. One, two, three, put the whole foot down and shift your weight. Two, two, three, roll through the heel, and tendu, and in. I didn't demonstrate the timing very well. One, two, three, four, five, and six, and we get to breathe here. You could sigh, you could sing. Ah, seven and eight. And we'll do the other side. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and then we'll do the side again to the left. Let's start with the right leg, shall we? Ready, here we go, and tendu. Shift the weight. Ah, beautiful. Other side. One. I love the breathing that you were doing. I hope we can breathe in even in our eyes, right? Let's take quick for our feet, dégagé. So we brush out to the tendu and we use the toes to push off to a full point. Let's go out and two and three and four and five and six and seven and suspend. In then two, and we won't suspend the music, we'll suspend our body. Seven and a eight, other side, then to two and a three and a four, eight, and then let's go to fours. One and two and three and four, oh, 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 one and two and three, other side, and then let's do twos, and we'll do twos twice. So it will have a nice shape. So let's just keep our arms forward, palms out, so we can focus on shifting from 1 foot to 2 feet and having this pliable foot in the dégagé that we just found in the tendu. Out and out and ready, here we go. One. Nice, go to a specific place. Other side. In fours. A little bend. Beautiful. Thank you, Sarah. That was beautiful. I think we're ready for some demi-coupes. This is another exercise I think is super important to try very slowly and also to try very quickly, and then we'll know if we're on our leg. The first time through, let's take it onto, we'll step onto the ball of the foot, but we don't have to go onto the rise right away. And this is the way I do demi-coupes now. Forward and forward, and forward, and forward. Then we'll go side. We have to make a choice front or back. Let's cross front, to the side, cross back. So I alternate, back it up. And a two, and a three, and a four. And then we'll go the other side, to the back, the six. And now we have to take two steps, and eight. And we could start again on the left side. One, and one, and one, and one, to the side, one, cross it front, one, to the side, cross it back, the back of the square, and around to the side. Let's get up on the one, sorry, my mask is slipping here. Let's get up on the one, release, one. Let's try it on that flat foot, and then let's repeat it, so Sarah, you can play all the way through, and we'll try to go right up to the demi-coupe, one, lower through a long heel, and the other side. This will be the test. The challenge, I should say. So let's have our right foot free. One, oh one, already. Let's walk, demi-coupe. To the side, that's it. Back it up. Your whole body's breathing. Yeah, one. Backing. And let's pause. Beautiful. Right. So we want to take our whole torso with us from the back of our underneath our shoulder blades to the front of the hips. So that's all in a beautiful column. We're going to need that later on for our pirouette so that this doesn't happen. So let's try that one more time a little quicker. And let's start on the left foot for variety. Left foot, one more time a little quicker. Five and six and ready to go. Ah. Demis and a coupe, other side. the back. And finish. Nice. Was it a little easier? Quick? Perhaps? Yes, yes, that does help. Yeah, we're three-dimensional bodies here. So let's move a bit. Shall we move in a circle? Let's make a combination of pas de bourrée and coupé, and let's do it in a duple. The pas de bourrée starts with a demi-coupé, and we'll start on our right foot, followed by two steps. And then we'll take a coupé, which starts with a demi-coupé and has one step. So one and two, one, two. And if I were to do it in a circle, let's see if we can do four of that phrase, pas de bourrée, coupé, to get back to where we started. So you'll have to look around your own space and see where you need to go to fit. Pas de bourrée and coupé. If you'd like, you can do pas de bourrée and coupé. Up on the one. If you've done opposition arms, you could oppose the first step, pas de bourrée, and then the second part of the coupé, exactly. Could you do that one more time? And coupé, and pas de bourrée, and coupé. Right, so you'll see Caitlin's landing the coupé in a long knee, which makes the measure nice and clean, and then we don't release until the beginning of the next step. So let's have our right foot free. Pas de bourrée and coupé. A little softer from the landing to the plié of the coupé. Yes. And let's pause there. Nice. Can we switch sides? We do want to end the coupé on a long knee, but we also want to smooth out that transition there. So left side. See if you can do four and end up in a perfect circle there. Great. Pas de bourrée and coupé. Let's do it again. Haha, nice. Are your arms breathing? Nice. Beautiful. That was so interesting what happened there. All right, so we could take those same steps in a triple rhythm just to see what that feels like. So the pas de bourrée still takes one measure, the coupé still takes one measure, but it would be one, two, three, one, two, three. So you can really get that coupé nice and smooth. We can't alternate to the other side. Let's do two times around and to the right. Pas de bourrée and coupé. Oh no, I counted in a duple. One, two, three, one, two, three. Make sure you can see everything around you again. And we'll pause. Nice. Let's do the other side. Try the our position arms now if you haven't done that already. Opposing on the first step of the demi-coupé. One, two, three, ready, and do we have to look down when we bend our knees? I think not. Again. Beautiful. Yeah, sometimes we have a tendency to drop our head on the plié, but we don't need to. We can keep the head up as we bend. Great. All right, so we have two steps to learn today for our Sarabande, the pas grave and pirouette. And both of these steps need to be grounded, so we need to be connected to our heels of our feet. because we don't shift the weight forward right away. We stay where we are, and bend and rise, and up and over. So we can make a little combination with our pas de bourrée and coupé, and let's in fact do it in a square. So I'm just going to back up a little. And do I want to stay in a duple or a triple? A triple. So that pas grave, we sink on the foot we're on, we rise up into first position, and we go up and over to shift the weight. And we could do another one. When we bend, remember to bring both heels under the pelvis, rise up into first, and you could shift your other foot. There's your pas grave. One, two, three. One, two, up on the one. The pirouette, just facing on a diagonal here, the foot goes behind into third position, and we bend there. We go up on the one, and we pirouette. We keep the weight on the back foot because we need to use that foot again to do something. For instance, we could do pirouette, step point. I use my right foot, pirouette. I need to use that foot again, so keep the weight back. Step, just try that for yourself, a little pirouette, step point. I think the trickiest thing might be that you have to use that foot again. Step point there. So shall we make a combination, friends? If we start with our right foot, we can make a box of this. One, two, three, coupe. One, two, three, pas grave. One, two, three, pirouette. I'm gonna use my same arm as leg. Quarter turn, pirouette. I have to use that foot again. Pas, two, bourrée, and coupe, and pas grave, and pirouette, quarter turn, and then you can go upstage. Let's see the dancers do this one. Pas de bourrée, and coupe, and pas grave, pirouette. Yeah, so we want to make sure that pas grave ends on a long knee and then softens to go into the next. And we can do a box that takes us fully around to the starting place. If you know your opposition arms, you want to practice them, we'll take the opposition arms on the pas de bourrée. Let's take the coupé again. And then for the pas grave, let's just open the palms. And if you'd like to use the same arm as leg on the pirouette, it would be great. And then you have to start again exactly. So you'll have some choices to make how to make that shift. Let's try it slow, and then we can try it quicker, perhaps. But let's do the right side. One, two, three, pas de bourrée. Here we go. Long legs. Beautiful. Starts with a demi-coupé. Rise. Pirouette. Beautiful shift of weight. Let's respond to the music that you're hearing. Nice. Beautiful. Right, so one more thing to add in is responding, of course, to the music that we're hearing that was beautifully sustained. Shall we try the other side? Do you need to shift your space or you're fine there? Let's keep that same tempo, Sarah. One, two, three, I'm ready. Here we pop. That was a beautiful step. Gorgeous. Gorgeous. I love the taffy, stretchy feeling of that that you found in your muscles. That was gorgeous, and it will serve you well in a Sarabande. Just for fun, shall we try it a little quicker?
Yeah.
Let's do it. One, two, three. Same, right side. One, two, three, ready, here we go. Mm-hmm. side. Let's do the left side, even a little quicker, just to see. It changes the character a bit, doesn't it, when it's a different tempo. One, two, three, ready, and on. Gorgeous. Nice. That was fun. Thank you, Sarah. I think it's time to look now at our opening phrase of our Sarabande, shall we? So let's take the first four measures of the Sarabande from La Bourgogne, and then we'll make it into a combination for class. So it won't be exactly as the notation because we're pulling it apart for our classroom combination. So we will start with our left foot crossed forward, or croisé, and I'm going to keep the ball of the foot on the floor. And right away we start with a pirouette, which means my left foot comes to be behind and my left arm comes up. We take a demi-coupé, I'm going to keep mine low, but the dancers will go higher, and let's do a little leg wave. Another pirouette, and here's our pas grave, right foot stays forward. Let's just look at those first four measures for a bit. So, we have to get up on the one. One, two, three. On the demi-coupé, we got to get up on the one, two, three. Up on the one, two, three. On the pas grave, one, two, three. And then we're going to take just three walks in a little circle so that I end up on the opposite side of where I am now. Left, right, left, and I'll point my right foot forward. And now I can make the exercise on the other side, which means right foot comes behind, demi-coupé with a leg wave, left foot pirouette, and we're going to go upstage, pas grave, three steps, walk, walk, and see if I can end up where I was before. It's something we definitely have to train ourselves in, how much space we're using. Shall we put them together and see if we can remember? The tempo would be one, two, three. Let's take it slow because that will challenge us. One, two, three, and then we'll open the arms on the pas grave, and then we just walk. You can put the ball of the foot down first, a walk, and we'll do the same combination. Other side. One, two, three, one. Pirouette, let's go upstage or to your left, and we take that curved path, a walk, a walk. Remember that column we talked about from the back of us to the front of our hips that will help us stay grounded. Shall we try that many times? And so our left foot is croisé front. One, two, three, ready, pirouette. Stand on the whole foot. Right side. Pirouette. Demi. Pirouette. Bravo. And pause. Good. You can play the second part if you like. Is that okay? It's not, so that it continues. I think we should do that again. So what challenges did we have? Choose something that you want to improve upon. Maybe you want to add the arm. Maybe you want to make sure you don't fall back on the pirouette, especially on the pas grave. We don't want to fall back on that, and that's that part of our body there. So let's try that many times. So let's always start with our left foot forward. One, two, three, Sarabande. Yes. Again, and nice. And one. nice. Shall we try that a smidgen quicker, the exact same thing? And then we'll look at the walk-around phrase and make it a little different. So we'll fill in the steps a little more. But I think we can practice this a few more times. So let's see. One. Nice. One. Two. Three. Let's do it again. And a little freer while you breathe. That's it. Wide ribs. Gorgeous. Yes, in some ways the shift of weight's easier when we're quick, but we still need to be right on our leg. And what does that mean? It means the torso from your shoulders to your hips is all in one beautiful column that breathes and twists and sees, and it's right over the ball and heel of your standing foot. All right, so in the Sarabande choreography, in the notation for it, we have a different walk-around path, which I'd like to teach to you now. So after we've done the pirouette and the pas grave, instead of taking step, point, let's take coupe, pas grave, coupe, pas grave. Sounds simple, but it's a very tricky shift of weight. And it's one of the things I enjoy about this Sarabande. So I finished, shall we go back to marking the pirouette, just as we did, the demi with the leg circle, the pirouette, the opening pas grave, and now in that same curved path, I'm going to take a coupe, which starts with a demi followed by a single step, a pas grave, rise and shift, another coupe, and rise and shift. We are not rising from our feet. We're rising from our brain, telling our body to lift us up and press the legs down. And that's the challenge. So let's look at what that whole combination could look like. I'll do it once and then we'll pass it over to you. We have pirouette, we have our demi, we have our pirouette. You can go a little upstage. Here's your coupe. It moves, it holds back. It moves, it holds back. And then we're on the other side. Let's just do one side though, because we have this funny shift of weight to get to the other side. But shall we do that one side? And see if we can end up exactly opposite from where we started. One. How's that tempo?
That's good.
Yeah, sorry. Ready, here we go. And. Coupe. Hold back. And pause. That's it. How was it? I want to watch it this time. We'll just do that much, Sarah. One, two, three, ready. And. There you are. Nice. Good. Excellent. So I think as we're working on the steps, we can also think about now, but where's our focus? Where are our eyes? And if this were a solo, I think I might want to keep my focus forward so I have that beautiful spiral there. Open here, fine. Maybe I spiral here and come around. And then let's take our eyes around for the pas grave and the coupe. Maybe we can find a little more vertical and twist around the vertical on the pirouette so that we don't keep the head forward on the neck without seeing anything, right? But we can enjoy that easy neck. And in the dance, I'm actually dancing with my partner who's across from me. So you could think about dancing with somebody and seeing them. Let's do the same thing, thinking about your focus. Make some choices about where your eyes are. And let's try not to look down when we bend our legs. We'll take it one more time on that side. One, two, three, ready. Hands. Yes. Coupe. That's it. Yes. Gorgeous. I think that made such a big difference in the way the body looks in space. So continue playing with that, and you can make other choices, of course. I think we should practice the other side and see what that's like. So that means we start, so Caitlin, you could demonstrate for me. So that means we start with the right foot forward. So what does that look like? Pirouette and demi-coupe. Pirouette, we'll go a little upstage with your pas grave and your coupe. Hold back a little, and your coupe, and hold back a little. Right, so we'll just take that much of it on the other side, and we'll do that a few times. It always feels a little different to do the second side. So let's start with our right foot forward. Enjoy, think about your focus. What do you want to add with your arms? Maybe you just want to breathe. One, two, three, ready, Sarabande. Again. I see Caitlin's adding the arm on the coupe. You can make a choice about that. You can keep it down. You can keep the palms up on the one. You could try an arm on the pas grave if you like. Go ahead and experiment. Sometimes it makes you forget what your feet are doing, and that's perfectly fine. Let's do the second side one more time. Right foot forward. One, two, three, ready. And nice. Beautiful. I love the coupe into the pas grave, especially when I'm dancing with my partner, because I can progress around the circle, and then I can hold back so I can say something with how I'm moving, progressing, and holding back. Now let's try to do both sides, which means we have a little funny foot shift. So let's see what that foot shift could be. If I start on my first side, and I'll just do it a little quicker than the tempo we're working on, just to walk through it. Pas grave, coupe, pas grave, coupe, pas grave. Now what do we need to do to get to the other side? I have to shift my weight, because this is just an exercise, to pirouette. Demi, pirouette, pas grave, coupe, pas grave, coupe, pas grave. What happens in the dance, actually, is that you don't put all your weight onto that last step. I think we'll have time to shift, but if you want to come around and just not put all of your weight there, you could try that, just so that we have a smooth transition and we can go from one side to the other, practicing being grounded even as we are rising up onto the balls of the feet. And I have to say, this breathing here really helps. So let's go. First side, second side, first side, second side. One, two, three, ready. That's it. Beautiful. Again, and pirouette, demi, pirouette. Second side, pirouette, demi. gorgeous. I love the seeing the breathing happening in the whole torso. It's a whole body experience, not just our feet, not just our arms and hands. It's our whole body experience. Just for practice and to see something different in the space, what if we put you two a little separated, starting on opposite sides, but let's keep your up-down distance. So let's have you facing facing straight forward. And Caitlin, let's have you start with your left foot forward. And just to see what happens with the symmetry in the space, even though we have our pandemic distance here, let's just see with my counting what this looks like. So we would go pirouette and demi and pirouette. And this part's different from the dance, but that's okay. Walk around your own circle. And da, ya, da, di. And then you start the other side. And pirouette, and demi, and pirouette, and demi, and walk. Yeah. Now you can keep it as an exercise. It is an exercise, but it's so interesting to see the symmetry and where it changes on our walk around, because I modified that part for the class. But I think for the fun of it, we can do it one more time on opposite, starting on opposite sides of each other, and do both sides one more time. Breathing, living, full body experience. One, two, three, you ready? And beautiful. Lovely. I think that really looks nice upstage and downstage, and it can give you some ideas for when you choreograph for a group or two people even, that you can do different things with the symmetry in the space. Beautiful. Thank you so much. We have a few more minutes to do a little springing. Shall we do a little springing? Just to get ready to spring, let's just do a first and two and three and four and five and six and seven and eight and jump and two and three and four and five and six and seven and eight and change. And if you can do eight more, go for it. Eight and 16. How fast shall we go, Caitlin? I'm not jumping really. How fast would you like to jump?
But you'd like it fast.
Well, yeah, I think so. Oh, one. Yeah, that seems like a good tempo. Shall we? Love it. Jumping, ready to go. Jumping, ready to go. Have a shape of the arms. Second, little space under the arms. Changement. Yeah, nice. Can you add some turns in there? Maybe some quarter turns? Whenever you feel like doing a little quarter turn. One more time of five and six and ready to jump. Changement. Gorgeous. Love it. All right. Let's take to finish. I hope you have room in your space wherever you are. Let's take contretemps pas de bourrée. And we'll take it in an S, which you often see in a dance minuet. So I'm going to start downstage or forward in whatever space I have available. And I'll take a contretemps to the side with my right foot free, hop, side, back, and then I'm going to turn my body on the line of action. Pas de bourrée. And then I face you all, contretemps, pas de bourrée. Third one, hop, step, step, pas de bourrée. Now I need to get back to the front of the room, so let's take pas de bourrée and step. And now I'm free to go the other way. Ha contra tumpin pa de bourre and contra a tumpin pa de bourre and contra a tumpin pa de bourre and pa de bourre and oh yeah. Great. Let's take for the arms. Contra tump pa de bourre. Contra tump pa de whichever arm it is. Let's see if we can do it twice through. The floor is a little slippery. What would be a good tempo, Caitlin? Is that a good tempo? Okay. All right. Contra tomp and pas de bourre. Again, other side. Great, we'll do that again. Let's be careful that we don't get too romantic with the body on the contretemps, but we'll keep the upright, but I love the turn and the cross there. So just not too much leaning in the body there. Let's take it a little quicker. Contretemps, pas de bourre. That's all right. That's all right, it's on all of us. Contretemps, ready to go. Yes. Small steps will keep you clean. Again. Yeah. One more time. Again, and. Beautiful. Thank you so much, dancers. Thank you so much, Sarah. That's all for our class today. I'm so glad you could join us. And since it's on tape, you can come back and take the class as many times as you like. You could also pause and repeat an exercise, which I highly recommend, so that you can spend longer time finding this grounded feeling and a full body experience. I'm going to finish with a bow to you all. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. See you all at the festival next season.